So let's go one step further past the decorator pattern that we built up just now. Since the object we are decorating is a brand new empty object, it kind of seems like we could just ask the car-like function to build it for us in the first place. That is where classes come in. The only difference between the decorator code that you see here and a class is that a class builds the object that it's going to augment, whereas a decorator accepts the object it's going to augment as an input. So if we move the object creation into the car-like function and remove the obj function parameter in favor of declaring a local variable, then we would have what's known as a class, and we would give it a different sort of name to reflect that fact. So a class is a construct that is capable of building a fleet of similar objects that all conform to roughly the same interface. It's conventional to name your class with a capitalized noun, almost like a proper noun for a category of things. The functions that produce these fleets of similar objects are called constructor functions because their job is to construct the objects that will qualify as members of the class. So to recap, the class is the notion of a category of things that you'd like to build and all of the entailed code that supports that category, whereas the constructor is simply the function that you use to produce a new instance of that class. The objects that get returned from these constructor function invocations, those are called instances of the class. So when we call a constructor function in order to create an instance, that operation is known as instantiating. At this point, we've reached an example of the functional class pattern because we have a simple function that produces instances of the car class.